Mr. Speaker, I rise in strong support of Senate Amendment H.R. 1204, the Aviation Security Stakeholder Participation Act of 2014, and yield myself such time as I may consume.
The gentleman is recognized for such time as he may consume.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, at the outset, I'd like to thank Chairman McCall and Hudson and Ranking Member Richmond for their support of the measure before us today. I'd like to thank Senator Tester for working with me to introduce companion legislation. Finally, I commend Chairman Rockefeller for taking an interest in this legislation and moving it through the Senate Commerce Committee on Science and Transportation. Mr. Speaker, the legislation before us today has gone through regular order and is the product of thoughtful deliberation and bipartisan agreement. Indeed, the Senate amendment to H.R. 1204 improves upon the bill passed by the House in December of last year by enhancing transparency while preserving the ability of the Aviation Security Advisory Committee to effectively and efficiently conduct its important work. By concurring in the Senate amendment to H.R. 1204 and sending the bill to the President for his signature, the House will be ensuring that stakeholders, including labor organizations, airports, small business operators at airports, airlines, have a permanent seat at the table when TSA is developing policy procedures that directly impact their work and business. When Congress established TSA in response to the 9/11 terrorist attack, the agency was granted broad latitude to develop, implement, and modify aviation security policies and procedures. As a result, in many instances, TSA is not required to and does not go through the federal rulemaking process to establish new policies or modify those already on the book. I've introduced H.R. 1204 to ensure that input from the key stakeholders is sought, received, and considered by TSA. To that end, my bill not only makes the Aviation Security Advisory Committee permanent, but puts new requirements on TSA to consult with this body and give its recommendations thoughtful and timely consideration. It also requires the establishment of subcommittees within the larger Aviation Security Advisory Committee to focus on air cargo security, general aviation security, perimeter security, and security technology. Whatever your views on TSA, I believe we can all agree that aviation security policymaking should reflect meaningful consultation and coordination with key stakeholders. With that, Mr. Speaker, I reserve the balance of my time.